Welcome back, everybody. This one's just going to be a really short video on how to set the Talkpod A36p into a scanning mode where it will scan the various channels that you have put into it. First of all, what we'll do is get the radio turned on and plugged into, and sorry, the programming cable plugged in. So give me a second here. So we can see it still. Okay, get the software started. Now we select the port. In this case, it's COM5. It could be different on your computers. If you want me to show you how to find out what it is, then just let me know. Now we click OK. And I will read the radio. Okay, now as you can see, I have five channels programmed in. Yeah, it's not a lot, but it's whatever. It's my local one and a few of the ones from around the area. Your programming is normal. Receive frequency, transmit, tones. Whatever else you need to put in. The other thing is make sure that you set the scan add by default is off. So you need to make sure that you add the channel to the scan list, or scan add rather. So you make sure they're like that. Now the next thing is it's really quite difficult to find out where you go to press scan. So the easiest way to do it is to create a short key. So if you go to edit and you go to optional features, and inside optional features you will see scan mode. Now inside scan mode there are three different ways. There's TO, which basically it will scan through each channel. And when it detects a signal on there, it will stop. It will obviously let you hear what's going on around there. And then when the carrier drops, it will hold, and I think it's about 5 seconds, maybe it's a little bit less, and then it will continue scanning again. The CO, what this one does is, again, it scans. When it picks up an active channel, it will stop and it will listen. And as soon as the carrier drops, it will then continue on scanning for the rest of them. And SE, this one, what it'll do is it'll scan again, and as soon as it finds a channel that's active, it will let you listen to the channel, and as soon as that transmission ends, it will stay on that channel. So it will not continue to scan afterwards. So once again, TO will scan. And as soon as the signal drops, it will wait for a few seconds and it will continue on. CO will scan, and when it hears a signal, it will stop and then it will listen. And until as soon as the carrier drops, it will start scanning again. And this one, it will scan, and as soon as it detects something, it will let you guys listen. If that person stops transmitting, it will stay on that channel. It will not go any further, it will just wait on that channel again, and it won't go any further. Now you can get to the scanning function through the menu on the radio, but I think it's easier if you set up a short key. So what I did is, if you go down to the next section down here, you'll see you've got the short key for the I've got the FM setup, which is the top key here. So when I press that and release it, the FM starts. When I press and release this one, the newer channels come on. So what I did is set up on this one for a long press. So I press it once really quickly, it will go into FM mode and it will start playing the local radio broadcasts. If I push and hold it, it will go into scan mode. So that's how you do it, basically. So what I'll do is I'll just unplug the programming cable. Close that. Now, if I push this once, this top one, see, it's gone into my local radio station. Well, Jack 96.9, it's, anyway, 80 station. And if I push and hold this button, however, I'm going to push and hold.
Scanning begin.
You hear it there say, scanning begin. And it's scanning. As you can see, it's flicking through all the channels that I put in the scan list. And hopefully it'll stop on something if somebody broke. There's been a couple of clicks on tonight where people seem to be keying up the repeater but not actually saying anything. So hopefully we'll pick up one of those. Okay, looks like nothing's happening. But it's just... Oh, there we go. And you see it stopped for a second and it continues on. I have this one configured in... Yeah, it's TO, so it waits for a few seconds and then it continues on. What I'll do is I will... Okay, so it hovers there for about 2 or 3 seconds. Not really that much, but anyway, so let's get the programming cable plugged back in again. Let's hope whoever is doing this keeps doing it, because it's helping this... You're not supposed to, but anyway. So we've got CO. Now this one will program, let's just do it. Write it to the radio, start. Okay, it is complete. Unplug, and let's start the scan again.
Scanning begin.
KC7HD.
Okay, I got them mixed up. As you can see, that was a much longer delay after the carrier ended, so I got those two mixed up. Yeah, that's a lot longer delay. Yeah, so those first two ones I mixed up. So the first one is when the carrier drops, it will continue scanning. The second one, which is what we're on now, when the carrier drops, it will wait about 5 to 6 seconds, I think that was, before it will continue again. And I'll just show you the demo of the last one. Let's get it programmed in again. So we go to this. And we go to SE. And we write that to the radio. Okay, let's plug that, set the scanning away.
Scanning begin.
Okay, so hopefully somebody will key up the repeater again. You should see it stop and it will stay there. Oh. And as you can see, it received a signal, it stopped there, and it is not continuing. So that's what the SE option does. Anyway, it's been a pretty short video compared to my usual ones. And that's just a quick one on how to get the scanning working on the Talkpod A36p, P mean plus. Okay, 7-3s everybody, and have a good night.